From a torturous asylum to a dangerous pond, here are the top 5 places in Australia you should never visit. Number 5 on this list is the Devil's Pond. The Devil's Pond is a very beautiful and calm looking body of water on the outside, but it's far more dangerous when you step inside. Located in the Queensland forest, the pond itself almost looks like something straight out of a fairy tale, but there's no happy ending here. 19 people have died in this tiny little pond. That's a staggering amount of people considering how small this one area is. In fact, so many people have had tragic endings here that there's literally a sign that says the creek has claimed many lives. Think about that. It sounds like something straight from a Scooby-Doo story. Beware of this pond or else, but like seriously, beware of the pond. An ancient Aboriginal legend tells us of how a runaway bride fell to her death here as she was escaping her wedding. The bride was named Ulana, and it's believed that she is actually the cause of the many deaths that have happened here. It's said that she lures and tricks people into coming towards her, and then they fall in and suffer the same fate that happened to her so many years ago. I'm not sure if the bride legend is true or not, but even if it isn't, this is clearly an incredibly dangerous spot in its own right. Australia is a big place, so don't feel like this is your only option if you're going for a swim when you're there. Number 4 on this list is the National Film and Sound Archive. Located in Canberra, which I actually just discovered is the capital city of Australia, always thought it was Sydney, but actually it's Canberra, so that's fun. But anyways, the Film and Sound Archive is a staple of media culture in Australia. It just hasn't always been that way. Crypto-naturalist Tim says the NFSA building is regarded by many ghost hunters or paranormal aficionados as not only one of the most haunted in Canberra, but also one of the most haunted in Australia. It's not because it houses spooky movies, though. The ghosts that are reported in the building stem from the period that it was the Institute of Anatomy. That's right, guys, this building, prior to being what it is now, was housing and studying dead bodies for 50 whole years. There were countless scientific experiments that went on here, on hundreds to potentially even thousands of corpses. During this time, it was a museum as well and showcased the dead bodies to those who visited here. Because of all this death, the place is pretty popular among the ghosts. Apparently, the dissection rooms are the most popular, with many paranormal sightings here over the years. There's also a little girl who many visitors have seen. She lives in the air vents of the building and pops out through the grates every now and again. Luckily enough, her intentions aren't evil though, and often tries to make people laugh. That being said, I still don't think that going to this place that used to house a bunch of dead bodies is the best idea. We have Netflix for a reason now, guys, so let's use it. Number 3 on this list is the Beechworth Asylum. Ah yes, the classic haunted asylum. It feels like every country has one, but Australia's is particularly bad. The hospital opened in 1867 and was operational until 1995, when it was finally shut down. During that span, when it was functioning, the asylum had over 3,000 patients die in its walls. That is an absurd number of people for a mental hospital. Part of this was because the methods that they used at this place weren't the best. Like most asylums that started in the 1800s, the treatments that they had for people dealing with mental health problems were far from ideal. Shock therapy, shackling patients up, just blatant torture were all things that went down at this asylum. Obviously, this didn't help anyone in dealing with their issues and caused a lot of people to pass away early. Now, these spirits of those who died here haunt the building. Screams can be heard ringing throughout the walls, with people thinking it's the ghosts of those who were being shocked or tortured. Some have reported seeing the ghosts of nurses walking around the building. These aren't your typical kind nurses, though. People have said that they look evil and unforgiving. Deep feelings of depression can be felt here, and just a strong feeling of uneasiness. Personally, I see absolutely no reason to visit this horrible place ever, and in all honesty, I'm kind of surprised that the building is still standing. Number 2 on this list is the Monte Cristo Homestead. Built over 150 years ago, this home has had such a tragic history that many believe it to be Australia's most haunted home, and honestly, after reading about the horrific things that happened here, I totally understand why. Australian Geographic writes, "A chain of violent events in the house have triggered other supernatural incidents. A maid once plummeted to her death from the upstairs balcony, and the figure of a woman in period dress has been seen walking along the veranda to the bloodstained steps where she fell. A stable boy who burned to death in his bed at the hands of his master is thought to haunt the coach house, while the ghost of a mentally disabled man named Harold wanders the grounds. Kept chained in the caretaker's cottage for 40 years, Harold was found curled up at the the feet of his mother's dead body. He died shortly after being sent to a home for the insane. The sound of clanking chains is said to warn of his approach. All of those things are super scary to begin with, but the most sighted ghost at this home isn't even mentioned there. Elizabeth Crawley inherited this house from her husband who passed in 1910, and her ghost has never left. After her husband died, she went into a deep depression and would rarely leave the home. She converted one of the upstairs rooms into a space to perform rituals. It's said that after her husband died, she only left this house twice and eventually died in it by herself. Now, you'll know her ghost is present because there'll be a sudden and stark change in temperature whenever she nears. All of this lore has, of course, created a ton of interest around the home, and it's been featured on several Australian ghost television shows through the years. However, you can also stay at this home if you wanted for $200 a night and experience all of this ghostly stuff for yourself. Why you would want to pay $200 of your actual money to get haunted and potentially even cursed is beyond me, but hey, to each their own, I guess. And finally, number one on this list is Port Arthur. Port Arthur is located in the Australian state of Tasmania, which is actually an island state 240 kilometers off of the Australian mainland. Port Arthur initially served as a penal site by the British Empire several hundreds of years ago. Towards the end of the 1700s, Britain stopped sending their prisoners to the Americas and instead started shipping them to Australia. What's even better than going to the mainland, though, was this small island state that they also owned in the middle of nowhere. Countless prisoners over the following decades were shipped off to Tasmania, with Port Arthur being one of the biggest final destinations for these criminals. Once they got there, their lives were never the same. Many of these people that were shipped here had committed small crimes out of sheer necessity, stealing some food to survive or something to keep their families warm. The severity of the crime mattered little to the British authorities, though, and even if it was something as small and insignificant as this, you could very easily find yourself stuck in this prison for the remainder of your life. The prisoners that got sent here were forced to work tirelessly in the timber, lumbering, and shipbuilding industries. Port Arthur actually boomed for the next 100 years, with more and more convicts being sent here. This was obviously very beneficial for the British government, but not so much so for the people who had to make this place their home. Many of them were mercilessly killed for no good reason. They were often tortured consistently if they weren't working hard enough or had done something that wasn't totally up to the standard. It really was a horrible way of life for those who got sent to Port Arthur. At around the end of the 1800s, Port Arthur started to slow down and eventually stopped altogether. The death of this location didn't end, though, because in 1996, Port Arthur saw one of Australia's darkest moments ever. 35 people were gunned down in a mass shooting that took place at Port Arthur. All of this death from various generations has caused Port Arthur to be one of Australia's most haunted spots. In fact, over the years, there have been more than 2,000 incidents of unexplained paranormal activity. Things moving, voices, shrieking, change in temperature, you name it, it's taken place at this location before. The asylum at Port Arthur is said to be the most haunted spot here, with reports of people getting scratched and touched by unseen entities. Port Arthur has had a horrible history to it, and it's not a place I'd recommend venturing out to if you do happen to catch yourself in the Australian state of Tasmania. Well, there you have it, guys. That is our list of the top 5 haunted places in Australia that you should never visit. Please comment down below what you thought about this list or some other haunted spots down under that I may have missed. Also, please hit the like and subscribe button. Thank you so much for watching. I've been your host, Nicholas Playalog, and I'll catch you next time.